Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, let's see how to group and filter the items of Vue Autocomplete component of Synfusion. If you look at this online example, you can see the autocomplete displaying different book names. These books are grouped under different categories like comics, science fiction, and thriller. You can also filter the specific book names that matches your typed in characters. I will show you now how to group and filter the autocomplete items using my Getting Started application. Let me open my existing Vue application where I have added the Vue autocomplete with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple Vue autocomplete, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this Getting Started example from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Now, to have better clarity and focus on these grouping and filtering features, I am replacing the remote data with JSON data collection, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely name and ID. Also, I have mapped the name field to value property. I have assigned the vegetable names to data source, so let me change the placeholder property value as select a vegetable. Also, ensure whether this data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the autocomplete. So here, you can see the autocomplete showing vegetable names. Now, let me show you the steps to group these autocomplete items. For that, I need to define one more field category with appropriate values on each object of the existing data source. Then, I will map this newly defined data source field category to the group by option within the fields property of autocomplete component. As the data item and data fields variables are already assigned to the data source and fields property of the autocomplete, so let me show you the output directly. Now, when you look at the autocomplete, the data items are grouped under the category leafy and salad and beans. Next, I'm going to show you how to filter the data items on the autocomplete based on the characters I type on the search box. To start filtering the data items, first, I need to enable the filtering feature in autocomplete. For that, let me define the property AlloFiltering and set its value as true inside the autocomplete code. Look at the autocomplete now. When I start to type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up displaying the vegetable names that starts with my typed in text. You can notice here, by default, the casing of my typed in characters are ignored during the filtering action on autocomplete, but if I want to consider the characters with same casing as I type in, then I need to set false to the ignore case property. So here, you can see the autocomplete. When I start to type in some characters in lower case, then you can see the autocomplete with no records as there are no items matching my typed in characters in the same casing. Next, let me proceed to explain about the filter types of autocomplete. By default, starts with filter type is applied while filtering the data items on autocomplete, but you can also filter the autocomplete items based on the other two filter types, namely ends with or contains. Now, I will proceed to filter the items based on the end characters of data items. So, I will define the property filter type and set its value as ends with inside the autocomplete code. And now, if I type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up displaying vegetable names that ends with my typed in characters. Similarly, you can also apply contains filter type if I want to filter the data items that contains your typed in characters at any of its position. Okay, let me show you now how to do filtering with diacritic characters in the text. Usually, when I try to filter the items that has some diacritic characters, it will be ignored during filtering. To show the working of diacritic filtering, first, let me modify the data source by including it with some diacritic characters. Then, I will define the property ignoreAccent to the autocomplete code and set its value as true. Here, I'm going to filter the data items which starts with characters by ignoring the case. So, let me remove the filter type and ignore case properties. As I have assigned the array of strings with diacritic characters to the autocomplete data source, so I will remove the fields property which is not needed. Now, when you look at this autocomplete, you can see the pop-up displaying the filtered data items that includes the diacritic characters. Finally, let me proceed to show you the working of autofill property, which autofills the remaining characters of the data item by matching it with my typed-in characters. Now, within the autocomplete code, I'm going to define the property autofill and set its value as true. So here, you can see when I type in the characters, then autofill control fills the remaining characters of the data item that matches the typed-in characters. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to group the view autocomplete items as well as how to filter those items. Also, we have seen the supported filter types in autocomplete and how to apply those filters as well as how to include the diacritic characters while filtering. Finally, we have also seen how to autofill the typed in characters in autocomplete component. If you'd like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos. Thanks for watching this video.